Hello everyone, welcome back to Storytime. We're going to be reading Winnie the Pooh, Half a Haycorn Pie today, and we're also going to be singing a song and doing a craft, so let's get started. Winnie the Pooh, Half a Haycorn Pie. Piglet loved haycorns more than any other food in the Hundred Acre Wood. In fact, Piglet loved haycorns almost as much as his friend Winnie the Pooh loved honey. Hardly a day went by that Piglet didn't make a haycorn pie, or a haycorn stew, or even a haycorn and jelly sandwich. Piglet even loved the little cups the haycorn sat in. He had haycorn baskets and haycorn picture frames and haycorn whatnots and knickknacks all over the house. So it wasn't unusual for Piglet to wake up with a craving for haycorns, as he did one morning in particular. And it wasn't unusual for Piglet to take his basket and go searching for haycorns either. But what was unusual was that Piglet couldn't find a single haycorn. There were haycorn trees everywhere, but much to Piglet's disappointment, not a nut to be found. "I'll bet a horrible Hufflepuff has stolen them all," Piglet thought when he got back home. Then he sat and began to wonder if there were any haycorns left anywhere in the world. "What a terrible place the world would be with no haycorns in it," thought Piglet. "No haycorns for pies or stews or sandwiches. No haycorn trees to provide shade or homes for birds or places to climb."
"You don't look very happy, Piglet," said Winnie the Pooh when he and Rabbit and Eeyore came to call on their friend. Piglet explained how there were no more haycorns left in the Hundred Acre Wood and how very sad that made him.
"There are always haycorns," said Rabbit. "We'll help you find some."
So Eeyore, Rabbit, Pooh, and Piglet went hiking through the forest. Pooh found a lovely tree with a hive just dripping with sweet golden honey. But he didn't find any haycorns. Eeyore found a field filled with prickly purple thistles.
"Mighty tasty," he said as he munched away. But he didn't find any haycorns.
Rabbit was determined to find some haycorns for Piglet, so when he didn't find any on the ground, he began to dig under the ground. Eventually, he found 4 haycorns.
"I told you I'd find some," he bragged.
"Not so loud," whispered Piglet. "There might be a horrible haycorn-stealing Hufflepuff nearby."
Rabbit offered the 4 haycorns to Piglet.
"Thank you, Rabbit," said Piglet. "There's one for each of us."
Rabbit, Pooh, and Eeyore quickly popped their haycorns into their mouths. But Piglet just held his haycorn and looked at it.
"Aren't you going to eat it?" asked Pooh in amazement.
"Not yet," replied Piglet.
When he got home again, Piglet carefully planted his haycorn in a special spot right outside his front door. Pooh scratched his head.
"Piglet, I thought you liked haycorns to eat."
"I do," his friend replied as he tenderly covered the haycorn with dirt. "But I want to have haycorns to eat in the future. And if I plant this one nut, in time it will grow into a tree with hundreds and hundreds of delicious haycorns."
Piglet spent most of the day watching the spot where his haycorn was planted. He was waiting for it to grow. Suddenly, Piglet heard a strange sound. He began to shake.
"Oh no," he thought. "It's probably that horrible haycorn-stealing Hufflepuff."
But it wasn't a Hufflepuff at all. It was Tigger and Roo. They came bouncing into his front yard, carrying basket after basket filled to the brim with crunchy golden haycorns.
"Surprise," said Roo. "We got up early this morning and picked all these for you."
Piglet looked at the haycorns and sighed.
"I'm glad you're not a horrible Hufflepuff," he said. "But no wonder I couldn't find any haycorns in the Hundred Acre Wood today."
"We were kind of hoping you'd bake us one of your Tiggerific haycorn pies," said Tigger, smacking his lips.
"Mm-hmm," agreed Roo, patting his tummy. "I don't think I could do that," said Piglet.
"You can't," said Tigger, disappointed. "But why?"
Piglet thought for a bit and then announced, "I know, I'll bake half a haycorn pie."
Tigger and Roo both looked puzzled, so Piglet explained, "From now on, I'm planning to plant 1 haycorn for every haycorn I eat.
That way, I'll never again have to worry about a world without haycorns.
Soon Piglet's friends were all merrily helping him plant haycorns in the 100-acre wood.
Piglet's half acorn pies have become famous in the 100-acre wood. And every time Piglet or Pooh or any of their friends take a bite of a half acorn pie, they know there will be many more half acorn pies to look forward to in the future. Somehow, that makes the one they are eating taste even better than before. The end.
Okay, for today's craft, we're going to be making a Winnie the Pooh honey pot. Here's what you'll need. A glass jar. Plastic will work if you don't have that. Some paint. Something to put the paint on. Some paint brushes. A cup of water to rinse your brushes out in. A strip of paper. And some glue. Alright, take your glass jar and get your paint ready. You're going to need some yellow for the honey and some more paint for whatever color you want the jar to be. When you're ready, take a brush a little bit on the larger side and start painting the outside of the jar. This is probably going to take more than one coat, so you can set it aside while the first layer dries and do something else. One thing you can do is start making the label. I'm going to spell honey the Pooh way, which is with a U and two backwards N's. Flip your label over. Get your paintbrush ready. And put a little bit of glue on the back. You really don't need very much. Use your paintbrush to spread the glue around and make sure it gets all corners. Now press the label onto the side of the jar and smooth it down. Good. Now you need to get your honey colors ready. Paint the top of the lid first, then paint drips spilling out over the edge of the jar. You can make them all different sizes. Again, you're probably going to have to use more than one coat. When you're done with that and have let it dry, your honey pot is complete. I'm sure you all did a great job. To finish up story time, how about a sing-along?
Winnie the Pooh, Winnie the Pooh, chubby little cubby all stuffed with fluff. He's Winnie the Pooh, Winnie the Pooh, willy nilly silly old bear. Winnie the Pooh, Winnie the Pooh, chubby little cubby all stuffed with fluff. He's Winnie the Pooh, Winnie the Pooh, willy nilly.